I'm sorry.
This should be closing.
Oh, wow. You're going to guys have
fun. And somebody.
What do you mean?
That's you.
Jeremy and Rose, joy and happiness in your wedding. Mahu hai, inad hatnad ko ang laas nalagaya at kasayahan sa inyan pag iisang didim. Physical, verbal, you have to practice 1,000 times to get it right. I did 1,199 of these things, so I hope that my skill level will pass. Marriage is a celebration, and it is right and just that we should celebrate the love of Jeremy and Rose. It has brought our two diverse families across a great distance. Rose's mother has traveled from Tapirong City, Mindanao, in the Philippines, to Houston, Texas, and then her family drove her all the way across the United States to Rochester, Minnesota. A total distance of 9,710 miles. Chaplain Wayne, you have taught us that love is powerful. It hopes all things, endures all things, believes all things. I would like to add a few comments to that. Love helps us cross great distances, as we've seen with the travels of Rose's mother. My wife and I traveled nearly 996 miles from Canyon City, Colorado, to be here. So, Rose and Leah, we are really happy that you can travel 24 hours on a flight to get here, and then a day and a half or 2 days in a car. Love is powerful like that. And God has told us in the Bible how we should treat love and how we should treat one another. It is not enough that we as men, when we get married, seek great wealth or seek adventure or excitement or great status or power or authority. God requires something else from us. He requires courage and understanding. When we come together as a family for the first time, we commit to solemn vows. Those vows are to defend the family courageously, to nurture one another, to nurture children and raise them with the values that God has taught us. And it's important that we maintain those values throughout our lives, because the family is the safety and security upon which we build all other institutions. Transition. Can you hear me now?
Start over.
It's not working.
You broke it again.
Right, Zach, take notes.
Okay.
Nope.
Hang on.
I can use my army voice if you can hear me as well. I mean, I can project.
Just shout in the microphone.
Just shout into the microphone.
Oh, he's breaking in. Oh, that's the third one.
Technical difficulties. Standby.
Oh, no.
You're the army boy.
Okay, so I'm going to project my army voice so that you can all hear me.
She's going to fix it, Jason. Just wait.
Sweet!
Love is patient, right?
So, some of the other notes that I have taken down is that Rose has not seen her mother, Rosalina, for 9 years. So we're talking about the distance in time as well as the distance in physical travel. And that demonstrates us the power that the institution of marriage brings us. And so that's very, very awesome. And I wanted to talk a little bit about that. It's not enough that men pursue great wealth, as I said, pursue status, power, authority. God requires something else from us, and that is courage to foster the values of the family. And it remains here, and it is an example to all of us that we must set the example and build the building blocks upon which all other institutions are built upon, whether it is our churches, our schools, or our government. Jeremy has waited a long time to find Rose, and Rose a long time to find Jeremy. So that it is right for a lifetime, and I hope that you find many years of happiness and joy. And we hope that all of us can join together and celebrate that. And it's right and just that we celebrate. So, in observing all of these things, I've come to the conclusion that love is very powerful. And through that, we can achieve all things through God who strengthens us. When I say that we need to be courageous, I'm an old veteran. I know that the world is scary and oftentimes very dangerous. There's all kinds of strange things going on, and it's hard to make the right decisions to lead the family through all the snares and traps that we find in our day-to-day. But it doesn't mean that we have to be supermen, or we don't have to be strong, we don't have to have any crazy attributes that is different from any other man. God gives us all the things that we need to get through the day to day. And we do that through one another. and through the friends and family who are witness to this love. Jeremy, 2 years ago when my wife Angie and I got married, he was my best friend. And so I was a little bit daunted in coming in and talking about Jeremy and Rose, because my twin brother is a professional writer and speaker. And I'm just an infantry, general infantryman. So it's a little bit scary to be up here. But I just thought that a couple of things I wanted to say is that Jeremy talked about in his speech that he is my best friend for life and also my best rival. He kind of kidded around that we even shared the womb together. Kind of an awkward moment of the speech. So it's my turn to remind him. Yeah, as I remember, I kicked you in the eye on the way out the door. So, awkward moment aside, I just wanted to say congratulations, Jeremy and Rose. I want to bless you, and I want to make sure that you know that I am here as your best man to protect and nurture the relationship and to be the witness of your love. And I ask all of you to also witness and be those protectors and guardians of the marriage, of the institution of marriage between Rose and Jeremy. Let us celebrate.